I often go to areas of great risk in the midst of conflict, but this is a totally different kind of danger. Giant hairy spiders have been panicking residents in a remote part of northeast India. Colonies of spiders have reportedly attacked people in Assam state. There have been two human fatalities, but it's not clear whether the deaths were caused by the spiders or by witch doctors who drained the wounds using razor blades. Well, let's take a close look at the spiders. We're joined by a spider and by the spider breeder, Stephen Newell, who's brought at least one of his spiders into the studio. Welcome to BBC World.
Good to be here.
I have to say it's the first time we've had a spider on set. Is it a pet spider? Can I
Yeah, it's a pet spider. It's one of my females, a breeding female.
Breeding female?
Yeah.
And can we get the spider to move a bit?
They don't particularly move very much. That's why they've got such a low metabolism. So they very rarely move, only when they have to.
Are they dangerous?
They're not particularly dangerous. There's no recorded deaths from a spider, a tarantula. There are from spiders, but not from tarantulas. I mean, this particular species, these are from India, but their bite isn't classed as very dangerous. I mean, if you were to get bitten, you might need to have hospital treatment. It depends if you're allergic to the spider or the bite, the same as with a bee sting, a wasp sting, but they're not particularly dangerous. They're not covered by any sort of regulations.
Because the spiders which are causing panic in Assam state in India are said to have been a previously unknown species of tarantula.
Yeah.
And the question is being asked, would they have caused the fatalities or was it something else?
If they're undescribed, then they could, you never know, they could have. But I'd be very surprised. They might be a closely related, not a tarantula, but a closely related species to a funnel web or a trapdoor spider, which sometimes have a more potent venom. But I'd be very surprised if it was a tarantula that caused the death.
And how many spiders do you have?
At the moment, around 300.
300?
Yeah, but that's quite a low amount for me. I've had a lot more than that.
Where do you keep them?
My loft's converted into a spider room, so most of them are up in the loft, which my partner doesn't like.
Your partner, you saw someone else's in the house, you, 300 spiders, and somebody else?
Yeah, and my partner, yeah.
Mm. Does your partner doesn't like it? Because a lot of people are afraid of spiders.
Yeah, she's got used to them. She didn't like them to start with, but now when you see them, she's got a lot more used to them now, and she realizes they're not as bad as people make out, and that's the whole point of it, I think. They're very they'll be defensive, but they're not aggressive.
And why did you decide to collect spiders?
When I was younger, 15, my mum and dad bought me some exotic pets, like stick insects and things like that, and I just progressed and wanted spiders. I just think they're cool.
And when you hear the story that we're reporting on today, which is a serious story about spiders, that people are actually panicking villagers because they're not sure about what the how lethal the spiders are. What do you think about that? Because there is this whole aura around spiders.
And I think that's half of the problem, where the media and things, they straight away blame the spider when quite often it's not the spider. I think once it's looked into, like you were saying with the witch doctors draining the blood, that could have caused as much the problem as the spider. I'm not ruling it out because it could be an undescribed species, but I'd be very surprised, very surprised.
So you feel these little insects are perhaps misunderstood?
I think they're very misunderstood. They make brilliant pets. Yeah, brilliant pets.
Now what would happen if we opened that up and the spider came out on the set?
These ones particularly are very fast, so you wouldn't see it. But once it's out in the open, they'll feel threatened and run
Would the spider head for a human being, or would they?
No, it would run the other way. I've never come across a spider that runs or tries to attack somebody. They'll rather run than attack.
Hmm. Do you think you're quite unusual, or do actually many people collect spiders?
In the UK, there's quite a group of us now that do collect them and do keep them. I think you'll be surprised how many people do keep them as pets.
Do you actually meet with your spider collecting friends?
We have regular meetings throughout the year, regular shows. There's lots of websites.
You and your 300 spiders get together with others with hundreds of spiders.
Yeah, there's a big group of people, especially in the UK, America. It's growing all the time, but it's becoming a very popular hobby. Mm.
Does your spider have a name?
No, I've got so many I don't name them. I've named a few. There's one at home called Claudia.
Well, an unnamed spider. And Stephen Newell, thank you very much for coming in and sharing your obvious enthusiasm for this rather unusual hobby.
Thank you.
So perhaps we should say to those in India who are afraid that perhaps don't be too afraid. It may not actually be the danger that you think it is. To a treat, not a danger, stargazers. The planet Venus has been in perfect alignment with the Earth.